Hello, everyone. Henry, come here. Henry thinks I'm saying hello to somebody outside. He's going to put on his hat for everybody. You are here joining us today. Henry, the workout today is called Feliz Navidad. Henry has his own hat, but he likes chewing on the hat, which he destroyed last workout that we did, Holidays with Henry. So thanks for joining me today. We've got a workout today called Feliz Navidad. Henry, over here. Come here, buddy. Come say hi to everybody. So you're going to work out with Henry again today. He's one of the best co-stars I have ever had in our 9 or 10 months of doing our workouts in the chair. So today's workout, what we're going to do, make sure you've got some water, right? Henry already had a lot of water in his water bowl. Make sure you've got some weights for later on, or some cans of beans or cans of soup to strengthen your muscles. What else are we going to need? Maybe a pillow. So over here we have a pillow, right, Henry? So you can have a pillow for your lower back. We also may be using the pillow to do some extra strength work for our legs or our chest or our abdominals and our back. Now today I didn't have any sneakers to match my outfit, so I am exercising in socks today. I don't recommend that you exercise with socks on because you don't want to slip on your floor. But I'm going to be very careful and I'm going to be sitting in the chair most of the time. Uh-oh. Did everybody just see what he did? He took one of my props. Hold on. Now, Henry really loves stuffed animals. And he's going to have a good time with Snoopy over on the couch. So you may not see him much today. All right. Are you ready? So let's get going. Let's have some fun today. If you want the pillow for your lower back, just put it right here, all right? So I've got 4 different series I'm gonna do, or 3 different series, just to loosen up all our muscles. Then we're gonna do a little aerobics to get the heart rate up. Most of the workout's gonna be sitting down in the chair today. And I think that's about it. I'll just have a quick sip of water. And hopefully we'll get Henry back here soon. He's having a good time with Snoopy right now. We're gonna do 10 of each exercise just to loosen everything up. The first one, we'll start off with shoulder rolls. And I'm gonna work our way down the body, doing 1 exercise for different muscle groups and different joints. And then we'll start over with different exercises for every muscle group and every joint. So we're gonna do that 3 different times, 3 different sets of exercises. Don't worry, I've got it all written out here. I got it all on my mind too. Let's start off with some shoulder rolls. So now when you do your shoulder rolls, remember, we don't want to roll way up like this because that just tightens up the neck. So you're just going to roll back. Roll back. So I'm showing you a side view. Reach back. And you'll see how even my elbows go back past my body. Roll back. Roll back. So think of tracing a clock. Henry, come on over. Come on, say hi to everybody. All right, so we've done 10 shoulder rolls, right? Rolling back, focusing on rolling back like this. Not way up here. You want to breathe out. Inhale, roll back, and exhale on the down. Now remember, we want to get the other direction, so roll forward. 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 That may be harder to roll forward because you might be tight in your upper back, so it's hard to roll those shoulders forward. But again, remember, I'm not stretching way up here. Next one we're going to do, this is called a head turn. So I'm going to sit up straight. Remember, you can have your back against the chair. And you just turn to the side. center. And then side. Keeping your chin neutral. So we're doing 10 of each exercise. 10 of each exercise. I'm not tucking my chin. Just looking neutral. If you want to have following a spot on the wall. Uh-oh, now he took another of my props. Here's the other thing. Try to have your arms here rather than here. So you're keeping the chest open. Stretch. Rotate. Rotate. Now Henry is working out his jaw today. He's being very gentle on the stuffed animals that he's taking. Again, thanks for joining me today. A couple more. Remember, take your time here. Now this is called a lateral stretch. This is for your back. You may have done this many a times with me on other videos. I also call this picking up the butter. Do you remember that? You went out to a restaurant once and somebody dropped the butter on the floor, the butter patty. Henry, come on over here and say hi to everybody. He's just tuning in. This is number 4. Now, if you've had any kind of back surgery, this might not be 100% good for you. Might not be comfortable. So only do what's good for you, especially if you have rods in your back. It's almost impossible to do this. Now, I'm sliding my hands down the side. Here he is. Come on, Henry. Come on. Say hi to everybody. Good boy. Sometimes he doesn't show you his best side. Remember, you want to breathe out as you lean to the side. Okay, good. How are we feeling? Great for your back? Sometimes I suggest bringing your arms up like this. So if you've done that, that's okay too. All right, now we're going to get our hips. I'm going to come to the edge of the chair a little bit so I can slide my leg out and in like this. Can everybody see that? Now, if you want more effort, we're just doing 10 of these. You could hold the leg up. And then, with your leg up, you may want to just put your back against the chair for extra support. This strengthens the thighs, but it's also very good for the inner and outer thighs, loosening up the hip. These are good exercises you can do any time of the day. I've got them all written out. We're going to do 10 on the other leg. So if you want a copy of these exercises, just call the Senior Center. They'll send me your email, or I can send them to you in the mail. Call the YMCA. So you want the 10 Feliz Navidad exercise. Now again, if this is a lot on your hip, you can have your foot on the floor. So this is for the inner and outer thigh, loosening up those hips. Okay, now we're gonna alternate kicking out from the knee. So you kick, down. Remember, you straighten out the knee without locking the knee. Henry, turn around and look the other way. Turn around and look the other way. Go ahead. He likes to look out the window at the snow. Come on, look at everybody over there. Yeah, look. He's like, where is everybody? Kick. All right, so you should feel this. A nice loosening up of the knee joint. Five. Out of the way a little bit, buddy. Six, seven. Again, if you'd rather have your back against the chair, you can have the back against the chair, and then the chair is supporting your thighs. When I'm back like this, my whole foot doesn't hit the ground. When I'm here, my flat foot does hit the ground. All right, now we're gonna do 10 pointing and flexing. So you can hold your feet up, you can point and flex like this. You could have them down here and point, flex, point. Oh my gosh. Can everybody see what's happening here? He just took another stuffed animal. He's very gentle, so don't worry. Nothing's getting all the stuffing taken out. So yeah, flex and point. So this is great for your calves, your ankles, your foot stability. You want to be able to flex and point your feet because when you're walking around the house or walking outside, this helps prevent you from shuffling. So you can use all the muscles in your calves, the ankles. Okay, so that was 6 different exercises. Now we're going to move on to my second set of 6 different exercises. Okay, how's everybody doing? Feeling okay? Next one. All right, so this is series number 2. You reach up. Up. So you want to breathe out. This is, again, getting the shoulders, expanding your rib cage. If it's not comfortable reaching this high, then just take your time or just go as far as you can. You should feel no pain. 5. 5. Now I'm going straight up. I'm not leaning to the side. 6. 6. 7. I'm trying to get my palms to face each other, okay? And 8. Henry, what are you doing over there? Get over here. 8. He's very guilty. You're not going to believe what he did. He took a couple balls off the penguin. 9. 9. 10. 10. Good. Now this next one is for your chest and upper back. I'm going to come a little bit to the edge of the chair. Now, if you can, if you're on the edge of your chair, you might be able to clap in back like this. Clap in back, clap in front. Now, if it's too hard to be on the back of edge of your chair like this, if you're on the back of your chair, just go back as best you can. The idea here is to stretch the chest and then also the upper back. So it's chest and upper back. I like doing this one when I get up in the morning, every morning, to get all the cobwebs out. Are you having a good time over there? I wish you all could see him. He's having a blast. He's on the couch. Here he comes. There you go. Say hi to everybody. Okay, next one is called rotation. This is for your back. So on this one, sometimes I tell people, if you want to hold on to the chair like this, try to keep your feet together. Try not to do anything like that. So on my first demonstration, this is a little better, just to turn. Now, if you want to have your back against the chair, that's a little better, because you're going to use your chair as your personal trainer to check your form. Make sure you're not leaning over. Oh my gosh, now he's got the Christmas tree. Okay, I gotta get that because my sister gave me that. You can't have that Christmas tree. This is the Christmas tree. Alright, he's very gentle. He won't rip anything. Alright, go ahead. You can see I'm a real pushover for my co-star. Alright, so we're rotating. This is great for the health of your back. To be happy in a million ways. For the holidays, you can't be home, sweet home. Okay, this next one. Have your back against the chair. This is for the hip. I'm keeping an eye on him. I'm actually going to have to go get that tree because I don't want him to rip off a button, okay, and choke on a button. So you're doing a little leg circle. Keep going. Hey, give me that. Okay. Okay, so the leg circle. If you can hold your leg up, you can use the chair to support. I'm circling clockwise, right? Circling clockwise, tracing that clock. Now I'm going to go counterclockwise. 10, 9, 8, 7. If you want to have your foot more on the floor, you can come more to the edge of your chair. Just make sure you don't slip off your chair. Hopefully your chair doesn't have any wheels. Remember, your chair should not have any wheels. Henry, come on over here. We'll play a little catch while we're doing leg circles. Okay, you're on the second leg. Everybody see how smart he is? He brought me the ball. Okay, here he is. Okay, so we're on the second leg. Circle clockwise. So we're doing only 10 of each. 10 of each. Concentrating on each joint, each muscle group. Hello, everyone who's been tuning in. I see a lot of friends out there. Fran, Joan, Audra, Barbara, Gloria. Circle the other way. Remember now, if you'd rather have your foot on the ground, Henry, come on and say hi to the new people that have been tuning in. There we go. So it was a good circle, unless you've got someone like Henry getting in your way from doing a perfect circle. Okay, the next one. We're going to hold one leg up. Do you remember when we kicked out from the knee? Now we're doing 10 on just one leg at a time. So this is going to strengthen the thighs. This is loosening up the knee joint. You're sitting up straight. Very easy right now. I'm not coordinating any arms or legs. We're concentrating on one area at a time. Okay, now we get the other leg 10 times. You push it out. Henry, look at everybody over this way. Look at everybody there. Look, see how smart he is? He is the smartest dog. 5, 6, 7. I wish people had tails so everybody could wag their tail all the time and show how happy they are, like Henry. 8, 9, 10. Okay, the next joint we're moving on are ankle circles. And this song coming up right now, Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer, if you wanted to do a little brain work, you could sing the song while you're doing your ankle circles. Make sure on the ankle circles, you're only circling at the ankle. Not the knee, not the hip.
Had a very shiny nose.
Circle the other way.
And if you ever saw, you would even
say. Now you should feel this in your calf and the front of your shin. Yes? As you circle. Because you're pointing and flexing your foot as you circle. Alright, let's get the other leg. Hold it up only as much as you want. You could have it down here to do a leg circle. You could do it even here if you felt like it.
With your nose so bright, won't you guide my sleigh?
Henry's looking for something else.
How the reindeer,
okay, he just found a sock.
As they shouted out with glee, Rudolph the Red.
I don't have socks just lying around. I put a couple out for him. Alright, circle the other way. Come on, Henry, over here. Back on the show. Good boy. I wish you could show everybody leg circles. You're showing them wag the tail circles. Good boy. I'll tell you need to get cheered up. Maybe I can bring Henry over and we can be in your driveway and say hello. That might be a good possibility, so let me know that too. You never know. Okay, now we've got one more set of 2, 4, 6, 7 exercises, 10 of each. Then we're going to do some aerobics. How's everyone feeling? I'm going to get a quick little water break. We're about 15 minutes into our program. Okay, now this one. I'm going to do both arms, but I'll only be able to show you one arm if I don't have wide enough stage here. But hold both arms up like this, okay? It's going to be palms up, palms down. Palms up, palms down. Palms up, palms down. I'm leaning against my chair to support my upper back. Now, if you want to turn those arms around a little bit more, Feel that through the shoulders.
Santa came to say.
But only do what's comfortable for your shoulder. Remember, I'm doing both arms at the same time. Henry, come on back over here. Everybody wants to see you. Oh, you're not going to believe it. Now he's sitting on the couch. Now, if it's not comfortable to have your arms that high, you could be doing it down here too. So you should feel that a lot through those shoulders, okay? This next one. Neck tuck. And straighten up. Neck tuck, so tuck your chin. Breathe out. I'm gonna tap my toes to this one. Tap my toes. Feel that stretching the back of your neck. I thought we could use a little peppier music by now.
I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas.
You wanna sing? Go ahead and sing along. It feels good. Tuck that chin. So again, you want to be feeling that all back here. All right, here's the next one. Are you ready? This is called a forward roll. This is for your back. Remember, we're going to do 10. Arms wide, feet about as wide as your hips. Breathe out. Remember, we like to keep our head above the heart here. Inhale, straighten up. So this is for your back. Exhale. Head above the heart so you don't get dizzy. Sit up straight. Exhale. Forward. If you feel like tapping your toes, go ahead. Number four. Breathe out. Inhale on the up. Come on, Henry, over here. I got another ball for you. Number five. Okay, stretch forward, sit up, we've got four more, he loves balls and he loves stuffed toys. All right, here we go, number seven, three more, number eight. Number nine. Ooh. One more for that back. Keep again. Keep the head above the heart. Number 10. Okay, now try this one. Now go back here. All you're going to do on this, scrunch up your toes and then relax. Scrunch up your toes. I'm gonna scrunch up my fingers too, just so you have an idea. So scrunch. 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 Scrunch it up. Now you can try this one later on without any shoes on, so you can really spread out your toes. You're trying to spread out your toes. Spread them out. All right, now there's one more area for your knees. If you don't want to stand up, this is the only time we're standing up today. You can just do some little kicks again if you want, all right? But what I want to show you, you've done these before, are the hamstring curls, where you kick your heel up and back. So if you can, stand up. There's a good range of motion that you want to have. And you see how I got distracted with my shirt and I lost my balance a little bit. So again, it would be like this. Up, down, up, down. So it's a good range of motion. Or the knee joint. But again, if it's not comfortable for you to stand up today, then just kick out from the knee sitting in your chair. But I'm giving you a lot of extra time to do this one. You don't want to come too high so you don't cramp up in your hamstrings, the back of your thigh. But this is a very important range of motion. Now I've done more than 10, but I wanted everybody to catch up at some point. All right. Okay, my co-star, come on. He heard and he perked right up. He's been sitting on that couch now, chewing on a ball. All right, is everybody ready? Let's get those heart rates up a little bit. So.
Merry Christmas, lady.
We're gonna run in the chair or jog. I'm gonna be on the back of my chair to support my back. Here we go.
Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse.
Feel free to sing along. Come here, Henry. Say, come here and say hi to everybody. Get off that couch.
Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Dashing through the snow in a one-horse open sleigh.
Now, I'm going to lean back against my chair a little bit to support my upper back and my lower back. I'm going to open up my hands a little bit. If you were wearing shoes and you wanted to hit that ground a little harder, go ahead. I'm being very careful in my socks. Remember, you really should not be exercising in socks. But I didn't have any sneakers to match my outfit. Now this is a 2.5 minute jog or march. I'm gonna change those arms just a little bit, but I'm gonna keep lifting those feet up. If anytime you need to take a little break, take a break, or don't lift so high. But I'm gonna stretch those arms straight ahead. Now if it's comfortable, you see I've got a very good chair that I can bring my elbows back like this, okay? Maybe your chair doesn't allow you to do that. Or it's more comfortable having your arms down here. Maybe your shoulders need a little break. I'm gonna stretch open my fingers and then I also make a fist. Henry, come on over here. Do a little jogging. Show everybody. I hope you're not on the couch like Henry. And just listening along. Remember, you should not feel this in your back. If you want to just tap your feet, if you're tired of marching, remember you could also be standing up. But this is a little more vigorous than all that listening and warming up that we did. The 10-10-10 workout that was prior to this. Woo! Let's get some jumping jacks. In a chair is out, in, out, in. Now I'm a little bit more on the edge of my chair so that my thighs do a little bit more work. Again, if you'd rather have your back against the chair, it could be like this. And only go as wide as what's comfortable for you. Now I'm gonna also add a little rotator cuff. Remember, it's a little bit more challenging now than the beginning. My whole foot is hitting the floor. I'm doing one leg, but two arms. Elbows are tucked in. If you have a healthy back, and you'd rather be more on the edge of your chair, you can be more on the edge of your chair. Now let's do some heel taps the next minute. Tap the heel. Tap the heel. Tap it out. Tap it out. Two arms on this part now. Are you ready? We're going to press back. Press. Press. Keeping my shoulders level. Again, if you got arms on your chair, it might be a little tough, so just do what you can. Do you see I'm keeping my shoulders level? Woo! Again, if you want to sing along to any of the holiday songs, that'll also put you in a good mood. All right, how are we doing with the workout today? I'm gonna have a little water, okay? Here he comes. Hey, here we go. He likes his song. I'm gonna reach up, same arm, same leg, like this. Up, down. Henry, come back over. Everybody wants to see you. Up, down, up, down. Come on, buddy. Up, down. You see how good he is? He's the best. Up, down. Up, down, up, down, up, down. Woo. Remember that you can also sing along right now, especially if you're home by yourself. You don't have to worry about spitting on anybody when you're singing. Lift. Lift, lift.
And a mingle in the jingling feet. That's the jingle bell rock.
All right, now let's get those inner and outer thighs again. Out and in like this. In, out. Cross, cross. If you want a little bit more work, then it's up to you. You can cross the legs, too. Now, you need to have a strong abdominals and strong back. So if it's not good for you, again, don't do it. Or you can lean against your chair more. And you don't have to reach for the knees. You can have the hands more on the thighs. So it's a little crisscross, arms and legs. Just my toes are hitting the ground. Be careful. If your calves cramp up, don't point those toes too much. I'm gonna hold one leg up. I'm gonna go out, in, up, down. Out, in, up, down. Now I'm using the chair to support my thigh. Just lift, out. Up to the sky, of course not up to the sky, up, out, up, out. You're feeling quite a bit in that hip and the thigh right now. If you want, I'm doing opposite arm. How are we doing with that? Is it easy as that, all right? Showing you this way a little bit better, okay? So it's up. Out. Everything's up. Everything's out. Henry, how we doing? This one's a little more for the brain and the body. Up. Out. Up. Out. Oh, he's taking a water break. Very good. Very good. Lift. All right, that's quite a bit on that one leg and that arm. So take a little break. Massage it out. Good. How are we doing, Henry? Say hi to everybody. Good boy. Good boy. Yeah. All right. Where's your balls? Okay, now remember, we're just doing the leg first to start. Just going out. No, that's not what we did. We went out, and then we lifted it, yeah? Out. Lift. Out. Lift. Just a little. Out. Lift. Out. Then I added the arm. The arm, we're trying to coordinate the arm with the leg. Everything lifts. Everything goes out. It's not comfortable to hold your leg up too high. Just keep it down here. You can go out and up. Out. So you don't have to hold it that high. I'm showing you the highest. parallel to the ground. Okay, this song's for my brother. His name is Johnny. You're gonna kick. Kick. Henry, you like this one? Kick. 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 So these are called karate kicks. Good for the knees because you're strengthening your thigh muscles. Kick. 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 Now I want you to do both arms, but I'm gonna massage Henry. He likes this one. Kick. 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 Woo! We sure did have a lot of snow. And hopefully you can see it outside, how pretty it is. Kick. Kick. If you're watching this on TV, last week, we were by the riverside, and it was a video that we played in May, just to get your mind off the snow. But we had to do Feliz Navidad today. All right, how are those knees feeling? You should not be feeling any pain in the knees. But I am getting a lot of muscle imbalance, because this arm keeps pressing straight ahead. Next one. All you're going to do is just get up and down. Give your knees a little rest, thighs a little rest. Heels. Heels. Come on, these are called heel raises, Henry. Show everybody. Heels. 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 I'm going to try to coordinate a little arms here. Yes. I'm going to press the balls of my feet into the floor as I lift those heels up. Now let's double check the arms. Watch this. Elbows stay right under the shoulders. Look at this. Can you believe he found another sock? Maybe I can teach him how to fold the socks. And there's a little comedy show besides a workout today with Henry here. He's a funny dog. As soon as I said that, he looked right over here. All right, how we doing? This next one. Now I'm showing you a side view, but I'm drawing a figure eight. Do you see I'm keeping my back against the chair? If you wanted to get your pillow right now, you could, right? If you felt like holding up a pillow. So now I am squeezing my chest a little bit as I'm drawing that figure eight and holding the pillow. No, 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 the pillow's not for you. Sorry, buddy. So everybody, I've got to demonstrate without the pillow. So I'm drawing a figure eight. Now lean back against your chair. You should feel your upper back, the shoulder blades against your chair as you draw that figure eight. Now watch this. Lift. 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 This one is slower. Inhale and exhale. Go in the other direction. We've got about a minute in the other direction. First, I'm just going to get the arms. Picture that figure eight. The infinity sign. All right, here I go. And lift. Lower. Lift. Lower. So this is for the brain, the body. Inhale. Exhale. Good. Very good, Henry. How am I looking? Okay? Inhale. Exhale. Woo. Now, as you lift in your foot, see, you can concentrate on keeping that ankle underneath your knee, for lining it up. All right. Fantastic. How was that? Feliz Navidad. Woo. Okay. We've got a couple more. Then we're going to do some weight training. Get your outfit. You ready? Okay. Next one. Henry, you got to get over here, okay? Good. Okay, sit down. You know, sit down for everybody. See if you can sit down. All right, who's on this side? This next one, you're going to hold your legs up. You're going to go clap, 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 clap. If this is not comfortable, you can have your feet here on the ground. Focus on the in. Focus on the in. You can have your heels on the ground going in and out. Or, if possible, try to hold them up a little bit. Or, if you want to just do one leg. So those are the different options. We're trying to work those inner thighs and a little bit of the outer thighs. So bring those feet together. And when you hold the legs up, it's a lot more on the top of the thighs, on the quadriceps, and your back. I'm leaning against my back. I'm leaning my back against the chair. If you've only been doing one leg, and you want to do the other leg like this, that's quite a long time. That's been about a minute. How are we feeling? Take a little break. Let's do some toe taps now. We did heel taps earlier. Now it's a toe tap. Toe tap. Point the toe, and then you come back flat-footed. Now, if you point that foot, and you feel a cramp in your calf, don't point that foot. You may be a little low on potassium, you may be a little dehydrated. That muscle cramps up, so you want to be careful. Medications can also cause that. Now, we do need to make some time for some weights to strengthen those muscles. So let's get our weights. We've got a new song. Okay. All right. We have about 15, 16, 17 minutes left. Here's the first one we're gonna do for our upper body. I've got my barbells here. I'm gonna press those arms back. Now watch. It's better for you to be here, more towards the edge of your chair. Go to the edge of your chair. Now do you see how fast I'm going? So let's slow it down. And let's show you from this side. Okay. Now, when I've got my arms like this and my back against the chair, I can't go so far back. Right? So, again, try it like this. I'm a little on the edge of my chair. If you'd rather be standing, you could be standing. I'm going to alternate the arms rather than doing both arms. Because you know what happens? When you do two arms, it's a little harder to go back as far as you could. So when you do one arm at a time, and you have the time for it, do one arm at a time. Because you can get a bigger range of motion. Stretch it back. Stretch back. So you should feel this in the upper back. The back of the arms. Breathe out. Henry, you want to come back and say hi to everybody? Come on, one more time. Well, a little bit more. Now, remember, you want to keep your wrists straight. You're not bending at the wrist at all like this, all right? My arm is straight. Not locking the elbow, but my elbow is pretty straight. And again, if it's better for you, And what I'm doing here today, I'm doing each of those arm exercises for about a minute. So anytime you need to stop, you take a little break. So you should have felt that quite a bit here, back here, and then a nice stretch here. Right, Henry? Now watch this one. Just one arm. You're gonna lift up to the front. Then you're gonna go to the side. All right, so you exhale up, no higher than your shoulder. And then over here. Come on, honey, there's room for you over here. Come on, come on. So lift. Good, can you sit down for everybody? Can you sit down? Good boy. Can you believe how smart he is? Now, if I could tell him to sit down and look at the camera. So remember, you exhale up, no higher than your shoulder. Breathe out. Okay, we've only got one more then, so that'll make us a minute on that one arm. No higher than the shoulder. Good. Let's get the other arm. Okay, Henry, over here. Good. All right, so everyone, it's up. And then out to the side. Again, you can have your back against the chair. So you lift. I've got a little bend in the elbow. When Henry comes to work out, it's almost like a spa day for him too. So he gets a little massage. You exhale up. You only go as high as your shoulder, no higher. You should feel no pain when you do this, everyone. No pain. Lift it up. And then out to the side. Great to strengthen your shoulders. We have time to do one more. Lifting up to the front. And then up to the side. Good. All right. Next one. I just want to get a quick sip of water. I hope you've been hydrating. Right, buddy? I wish you could see the look on his face. Henry, can you sit down and look at everybody? Look that way. Can you turn around? All right, well, he's got a good side. This is his good side, too. Next one. Let's take a little rest on those shoulders. We're gonna do bicep curls, you know that one, where the elbow stays tucked under the shoulder. So the shoulder is just a stabilizer. I'm gonna do one arm so I can concentrate on that arm, and also so I can pet Henry. I'm only gonna do one arm for 30 seconds, and then I'll switch arms. Remember, you gotta keep the elbow under the shoulder. Here's the side view. Elbow stays underneath that shoulder. You got exhale on the up. You want to feel it quite a bit here. Okay, time to switch. Remember, it's only 30 seconds on each arm. So I'm going up, down, up. Over this way, Henry. Down. You're in my range of motion. Up, down, up. Now, I was leaning over a little too much. Make sure you are sitting up straight. Shoulders are level. Exhale up. You're not tightening up the wrist. I mean the fingers. It's right here is where you're feeling it, right here. Good. All right, how's that going? Everybody okay? Next one. This will be for the chest and upper back. Shoulders. I'm going to hold my arms up like this. I'm going to only do one arm so it's not too much. So put that one down. You see how my elbow is lined up with my shoulder? I come in and I come out. Now watch, I'm putting my fingers here so I squeeze the chest. Oh, good. Henry, not on film. So I inhale And then I exhale forward like this. Now, if it's not comfortable, you can do this without the weight. If you need to have it a little lower like this, it's not as much chest. Okay, so this is quite a bit on that shoulder. Holding that arm up like the letter L. Okay, you've only got one more. We're only gonna do about 30 seconds on this side, okay? 30 seconds aside. Now you just bring it down like this. Nice and easy. Okay? So I'm starting here. My arm is like the letter L. And watch, it's not forward like this. It's like it stays like the letter L the whole time with the elbow over the wrist, over the shoulder. I haven't done this one that often with you, so I can't see you to check your form. But I thought for a Feliz Navidad workout, we would try it. So again, my fingers are here, squeeze the chest, doing your best to hold that arm up. If you need to have it come down or not use your weight or your can of soup, whatever you're using, can of beans, I've got my fingers here so I can feel that chest squeeze. Try it one more, ready? So that is a lot of effort on those shoulders. Okay, bring it down. Boy, Henry's a little tired, huh, Henry? You okay? We're almost coming to the end. That's right. Should we do one more with the weights? Or was that enough? I think what I'd like to do instead, I think you've done enough weights. I just want to show you a few things that you should do for your hands, some stretches. All right? So let's hold one hand up. You're going to flex your fingers like this and then stretch. So this is a little bit coming towards the end. Okay, fingertips up and then down. Try the other one. So this is from the Arthritis Foundation. Boy, that was good range of motion there, Henry, on the hip. Fingertips up and then down. Nice and gentle. Fingertips up and down. Okay, now go to the first hand. Circle at the wrist. Now, if you want to hold it down here, it's a little easier on your shoulder. And again, I'm only circling at the wrist. Circle in the other direction. Merry and brown. All right, now I've got to do this hand. And may all sorry, Henry. Circle. Be wise. Again, you can have it down here. Circle the other way. Having a dog is also good because you've got to pet the dog, and that's good for your arthritis in your hands. Give the dog a massage. This next one I'm going to show you, you've never done with me before, and I wanted to get a little box here. If you have time, go get a book or just something flat. Actually, I got something else. Cutting board even. Okay. So this is great. Coming a little closer so you can really watch my fingers, Henry. Okay, do you see how I've got my fingers like this? So it's not playing the piano, but I want you to coordinate your fingers of each hand like this. So I've got thumbs, pointy finger, middle finger, ring finger, pinky. So then you go to the ring finger, middle finger, pointy, thumb. Then you try to pick up the pace. But the slower you go, that also makes it challenging. So mixing up the pace is very good. But again, the same finger of each hand
busy sidewalk.
Try to hit. Now you can go in the opposite direction, or you can do middle, pinky, thumb, pointy, so I could call it out.
Children laughing, people passing.
Pinky, pointy, thumb. So you can't see because Henry's now in the way. So that's a new one that I just wanted to show everybody. All right, how are we doing on time? How are we doing on time? Anybody know who's singing this song? Don Ho. Yes. All right, let's do a little stretching for the shoulder. We've got about 4 more minutes, everyone. 4 more minutes. Pull that arm across. Feel that stretch here. All right, stretch the other day. So let me know if you liked this tempo. This is a little different than some of the other videos you've seen. Trying to mix things up for you. If you want a copy of my 3 different series of stretches to do, they're great to do in the morning or any time of day, even during a commercial. Let's get this range of motion. How are we doing, Henry? Come on over here in the camera. There you go. He knows we're coming to the end. See how I'm scratching my back here? Getting that good stretch. Try the other side. Can you sit down, Henry? Can you sit? Go ahead. Sit down. Good boy. All right. Again, do the best you can with that stretch. That's a tough one. Try to reach it. I don't expect everybody to be as good as me. Remember, I'm a trained professional. I've been doing this for over 34 years. Another good stretch to do that we haven't done. If it's comfortable for you, I'm doing some random stretches right now, going to different areas. Ankle over the knee, or the figure four. That's not comfortable. Remember, tap, tap, tap your glutes. Kind of hard to see because Henry's in the way. So here's the other side. You would tap, tap, tap. So again, you'd rather be like this. I'll give you a little time. But remember, hip and knee replacement, this is not a comfortable stretch. Anybody remember who's singing this one? He also sang the song More. I've played that before. His initials are BD. Bobby. Bobby Darin. All right, let's get the back of our legs. This is another area that's important to stretch. I've got my heel on the ground. You probably can't see that too well. Feel that nice stretch. For a Christmas. Now you can also go up and down that thigh like this. That helps the blood flow. I think Henry's gonna fall asleep on this one. Switch. So I'm digging my heel into the ground. Feeling that stretch behind the thigh and then on the top of the thigh. Another good thing to do towards the end of a workout, it's called La Jin. It's an ancient form of healing where you do circles like this on the knee joint or any joint. I know, Henry. You're a good boy. Circle the other way. So this helps the blood flow to the joint. You can do this on any joint. You can do it on your shoulders. This. Then you go up and down, so it's north to south. You can go east to west. Then you can just do a little tapping. Right? Little tapping. circles, up and down, back and forth, on the thighs, on the arms. Henry likes this one. You like the tapping, huh? Yes, you do. Tap, 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 tap. Up and down. Palms up. You can come across your chest. You can come across the chest. You can even come across your abdomen. Shake it all out. How we doing? All right, everyone, what do I have to say? Thank you. Henry, look up here at everybody. Look at the camera. Say goodbye to everyone. It was great being with you today, working out. We had a good time. We'll see you again soon. If we don't see you before the new year, happy new year. Have a great rest of the holiday season. And again, let us know how you're doing. It's great to see you all. Thanks again for joining me online or at the YMCA or Sunday when we're back at the Westport Senior Center. All right, everyone, have a great holiday. Henry, one more. Say goodbye to everyone. He hates saying goodbye. Bye-bye, Henry. Bye, everyone.